Good morning, children. Yesterday we had started with the plant kingdom. The first class of the plant kingdom is the non-vascular plants. That means they are without xylem and phloem. And the first class of the non-vascular plant is thallophyta, in which algae belongs to. They are generally called as algae. Here I have written some common characteristics of class thallophyta or of algae. They are totally aquatic. They are known as algae. Their body is thallus-like and their body cannot be divided into root, stem and leaf, not present. And common example of Spirogyra and Volvox. First, I want to show you some of the algae which are given here on the page number 31 of your book. These algae are, you know, the Volvox, it is a colonial algae. This is Chlamydomonas, it is a unicellular algae. This is Chara and this is Spirogyra also I have drawn, it is a filamentous algae. So all these top line is of green algae. Algae can be divided as green, brown and red algae. So these are all three are, and including Spirogyra, four are green algae. Then it comes the brown algae. They have shown here, this is Laminaria, this is Fucus, this is Dictyota, these are brown algae. This is Porphyra and this is Polysiphonia, these are red algae. So we can see that algae are of different types, red, green and brown according to the pigments present in them. Now it comes the general characteristics of the algae which are given here on page number 30. First of all, as we were discussing that they are simple thalloid and autotrophic structure. Some of the example are Chlamydomonas eulothrix. They have given in first paragraph. No need to discuss it again. Now come to here the methods of reproduction in algae. The method of reproduction, all the three method of reproduction are there in algae. That is vegetative reproduction, asexual reproduction and sexual reproduction. Asexual reproduction, first of all, the vegetative reproduction takes place by the process of fragmentation. Asexual reproduction takes place by the juice spore formation. I want to show you what are juice spores. Juice spores are like this. I have drawn and I am sending this page to you also. These are the flagella and this is the shape. And juice spore even can be like this also. Flagella can be terminal and flagella can be lateral. These are lateral flagella, these are terminal flagella. So these are juice spore, which are the means of asexual reproduction in algae. Then it comes the sexual reproduction as shown here. The sexual reproduction can be with the help of the gametes, and if the gametes are similar size as they have shown here in the Chlamydomonas, but they are flagellated. Example is Chlamydomonas. If they are similar size and flagellated, then it is isogamous condition because of the similar size. But if they are non-flagellated and similar size, so example is Spirogyra. In some of the species of Chlamydomonas, the gametes are dissimilar in shape and size, then this condition is called as anisogamous condition, and that way the fusion of, if the gametes result into the formation of zygote. But if in this case, in anisogamy, if the female gamete is larger than the male gamete, then it is called as oogamous condition. So these are the some condition of the gamete: isogamous, anisogamous. If it is anisogamous, it can be oogamous. Again, I am showing you the diagram of isogamous gamete. These are two same size, shape, structure is there. They are called as isogamous. If the female gamete is larger, male gamete is smaller, then this condition is called as anisogamy. But here female gamete is larger, so that condition will be called as anisogamous oogamous. Okay, now it comes the next page, that is page number 32. Now open page number 32 of your book. Here the most important part of this paragraph is, you can write here that it is the economic importance. It is the, you can put the heading here that this is the economic importance. I have given you the question. I am sending the questions also today. Economic importance of algae. You can put the heading here. Now algae, as I told you, can be divided into red, green and brown algae. So all the algae have their different economic importance. First of all, algae are the, you are to make the point here. Okay. So first of all, the algae are the primary producer of energy, and many aquatic organism depends on these algae. Number one. Number two, out of the 70 species of algae, the Laminaria sargassum, these species, these are the brown algae and they are used as a food. Then it comes the brown and red algae also produces a hydrocolloid. Algaeine is a hydrocolloid produced by brown algae and kerogene is a hydrocolloid produced by red algae. It is used commercially. And then one substance is there, agar. Agar is produced by Gelidium and Gracilaria. These are red algae. It is used in the culturing of microbes and preparation of ice cream and jellies. One of the algae Chlorena and one more is their Spirulina. These are unicellular algae and they produce, they are very rich source of protein and the protein prepared by them is called as single cellular protein, SCP. Nowadays, protein prepared by Spirulina is used very much and it provides the immunity also, so that it is very much in nowadays. Thank you. Now I am preparing the next video for today.